Your favorite main character loses to Giorno Giovanna. The strongest character of your universe, huh, say hello to Giorno. That's the strongest move of your verse? Psh, guess who beats that? Giorno Giovanna. Now, if you've ever gotten into arguments about fictional characters and have that one JoJo friend, you've probably heard things like this. Giorno Giovanna and his evolved stand, Gold Experience Requiem, are a known problem solver when it comes to versus battles. There are a lot of people that hear that he's broken, but why is it? And how far do his abilities go? Well, we'll be going over that here. But before we do, a large percentage of the people that do frequently watch my content are subscribed, so if you do watch me a lot, feel free to sub. It helps a lot, it's free, and you can unsub at any time. Gold Experience Requiem has the power to revert actions and willpower to zero. Well, what is zero? Let's look at our primary example in Diavolo. Here we can see Diavolo talking down to Giorno. This is the state of zero here. After this, he goes on to attempt to strike Giorno and take him out. But it turns out that he's never actually left his initial spot. We see him try to take out Giorno, but that event never happened. All the time that passed after that point of zero didn't actually happen. That is Gold Experience Requiem's revert to zero ability. Now, some may be thinking, well, wait, I've seen something like this before, and you probably have. A typical connection that I see people make is Itachi's Izanami. I've even seen people make the connection to Yoshikage Kira's Bites the Dust, but that just covers the loop aspect of it. What makes GR so special isn't just the ability, it's the range and level that it's used at. So to do that, we must look again to Diavolo. Diavolo's stand is King Crimson. With its ability, it can erase time and see into the future, both up to 10 seconds. Now, to manipulate time itself is a considerably large feat, as it's the fourth dimension, or well, how it's normally interpreted. Imagine this. If life, or well, consciousness, perceives everything in three dimensions, time itself stands out of it. Now, imagine this. Diavolo stands outside of time with the ability to manipulate it. That makes him a threat with fourth dimensional capabilities. But seeing as that it's a 10 second time limit, he's most likely on the lower end of it all, as characters do similar things but with no limit present. But now there's Gold Experience Requiem, who stood outside of Diavolo's time erasure with the ability to revert it. They stood outside of the outside. So, considering in just this ability alone, they define themselves as an extremely powerful character, seeing as now they're not the same level of fourth dimensional capabilities. Gold Experience Requiem puts itself fairly high up in comparison to many characters out there. So let's put this into practice. To use an example, say we have Naruto and Kurama. They're cool, neutral mindset. This is happening now. But now it's time to attack, and then they shoot a Biju bomb. Well, what would happen here? From what we've established, nothing. Nothing would happen here. Gold Experience Requiem can and would revert the action and mind state of Naruto back to the neutral point before the attempt. Nothing gets done. Now, this doesn't automatically mean that Giorno has won. This situation means that there's just going to be no progress whatsoever in the fight. Because let's consider the characters that we have here. We know that Naruto is strong. He's taken a lot of beatings and given a lot of them too. Let's say that we take Naruto down to a point of the biggest thing that he could do is just destroy an entire country in one go, right? Let's just lowball him to that extent. The largest thing that he can get hit by is a move of, let's say, the same caliber. Country level attack potency and durability for the sake of the scenario. In what small time that we had with Gold Experience Requiem and the feats that we've seen with regular Gold Experience, it would be pretty hard to put Giorno on that level of strength, right? So say that Giorno can't harm Naruto to damage like that. He can't win off of his strength alone. Then there's Naruto, who can't harm Giorno at all. With both fighters unable to do anything, you call this a stalemate, as nothing is progressing. Now, there are arguments that I've seen about the potential capabilities of GR, and that's great. Like, let's say this becomes a war of attrition, or Giorno has time to try different life giver forms to defeat Naruto. Like, we're switching it up, we're creating a snake with poison stronger than purple haze, and this is finally gonna get to Naruto because he has the time for it, because they're consistently just looping and looping and looping, and sooner or later Giorno wins the fight. That's a one of those scenarios, but that's not necessarily the conversation I'm trying to have here. The idea is that Giorno can stalemate a lot of fictional characters out there. He can definitely defeat a lot of them too, like just out completely outright within his like strength and everything, but it's the idea that he has this power to stalemate characters that would in most cases completely take him apart down to the very atom. Frieza can blow up Earth and breathe in space. That doesn't really matter because he'll never get the opportunity to blow the Earth up, as Gold Experience Requiem will revert every action to zero. Things like that. That's a ridiculous power, and it's all Giorno to hold. Or well, more so just Gold Experience Requiem, as it's the one in control here. In addition to the unfathomably strong ability that is reverting to zero, we also have the Infinite Death Loop. The Infinite Death Loop is what I believe to be an extension of the Revert to Zero ability. If Gold Experience Requiem were to kill you, you would experience death infinitely. It's more so actually that what will kill you does happen, but you never actually reach the end or the death itself because the death situation occurs right after that. You never get the release of death. And then that just continues infinitely. So, well, what's happening here? Well, the infinite death loop is a manipulation of reality. Usually, when there's a cause of death, there's the effect that is death following suit right after. Gold Experience Requiem manipulates reality to where the effect doesn't necessarily exist in the situation. It just becomes another cause. In addition to that, every death is different from the last. So, when considering the extent of the power that Gold Experience Requiem has, it's safe to say that this is not your usual suspect. The best opponents you can find for Giorno usually happen to be the ones that put his capabilities into question, the ones that challenges causality or reality manipulation, all that. There are many characters out there in fiction, but that's not necessarily the case when it comes to JoJo. And that's Gold Experience Requiem. Thank you all for watching. If you wanted to go even more about the aspects of certain things like, I guess, causality manipulation or things like that, I can go about it in a more grander scheme idea later on, I think, to make it more than just purely about Gold Experience Requiem, because there's so many characters out there in fiction that I could probably do that. Leave a like if you did enjoy, subscribe to stay updated, and just hopefully I'll see you all in the next one. So, until then, peace out, and Godspeed.